Good morning, my dear students. I hope all of you fine and safe at home. Today we will start our computer class. In this video, we learned the chapter 1, laptop and iPhone basics. You all are very happy when you are hearing this topic because of all of you know very well about these devices, laptop and iPhone. So, this chapter, all topics are based on questions. Shall we go to the first question? First question is, what is a laptop computer? I'll let you know this answer. Is it this? Then, what we can say this answer? The laptop can be easily carried. Is it correct? It is used in various places. It can be used by single person. Is it correct? So how we can say this definition? Laptop is a personal computer that can be easily carried and used in wide variety of location. Once again, what is laptop computer? Laptop computer is a personal computer that is can be easily carried and used in wide variety of locations. Understand? Then, what are the functionality used in the desktop? Desktop means personal computer. That functionality all will be available in this laptop computer. Then, what are the files? What are the devices are attached to the computer? What are the softwares are in the desktop computer? All will be available in the all we can access in the laptop computer. Did you get it?
Yes.
Next question is, how is a laptop computer differ from the desktop computer? Do you know desktop computer? In our computer lab has many computers. That computers are desktop computer. It is also called as personal computer or PCs. Do you know the laptop computer? Government is issuing free computer for the student. That computers are laptop computers. Now you can see the difference from their appearance. Can you? What is the difference? The desktop computer, monitor, keyboard, then mouse, all will be connected separated. All devices are connected separated. But in the laptop computer, monitor, keyboard, speaker, all devices are built in together in one device. So laptop has an all in one design. Is it correct? Then this laptop also have the option to connect ordinary mouse. Then large screen we can connect in the laptop. We can connect other devices, scanner, printer, like that devices also we can connect the connect in the laptop. After connecting these devices, it look like a personal computer. You know, no difference between laptop and the desktop computer. Is it correct? But it has one different main difference. It has what is the main difference? In the laptop computer, we can easily remove this, disconnect these devices and take laptop easily. Is it correct? The desktop not like that. Did you understand the main difference? What is the main difference? We can easily disconnect the peripherals. Peripherals means what are the devices connected into the computer? All are the peripheral devices. Okay, we can easily disconnect the peripheral device and take the laptop easily. Some other main difference also there. They are touchpad, battery, AC adapter and port. First we will see about touchpad. It is also called a trackpad. It is a touch sensitive pad. That means wherever we are touching, that all places are sensible. Understand? Then we can control the pointer by dragging on the pad with our finger. Do you know mouse pointer where it is? It is on the screen. That pointer will be controlled by our hand by dragging on this pad. Did you get him? Nowadays, many touchpad have multi-touch gestures. This multi-touch gestures we will study in the next chapter. Did you get? Next one is battery. Do you know inverter? Nowadays, most of the home has the inverter. What is the use of it? It is used to store the electricity. That is, it have the backup power. Understand? Why they are using? Whenever the power is not there, they can use the power from this inverter. Did you get it? Same way, the laptop also using the battery. It have the backup power. Whenever the power is unplugged, that time the power is taken from this battery. When we are plugging into the power, that time automatically the battery is recharged. Understand? Next one is AC adapter. A specialized power cable called an AC adapter. The cable we know that is a wire, power supply wire. That AC adapter is nothing but that is a power supply wire. Some cables uses magnetic MagSafe connector. It is used to safely disconnect the wires from the device. We are doing like this, we can avoid the damage to the cable and the laptop. Understand why we are using this one? To avoid the damage to the cable and the laptop. Did you get it? Next one is port. Normally we can say that socket or plug point. If you want to charge your mobile, what you will do? Plug the charger on the socket. Charger in the socket, then it will start the charging. Is it correct? Same way that sockets are available in the laptop, that only we are seeing port. These ports are used to connect the various devices into the laptop. Did you get it? What is the use of these ports? To connect the various devices to the laptop. Then most of the laptop and the desktop have same port, but some laptop have the fewer port because of it want to save the space. Did you get me? Some of the port may be different. That time they using the adapter to use that particular device. For example, the monitor port. That monitor port is normally it is big in size. That's why they are in the used in the laptop mini display port. That mini display port is smaller than the ordinary display port. Next question is, what is a netbook computer? These netbook computers are smaller than the laptop computer, so we can carry easily than the other computers. It is cheaper than the laptop and desktop computers, but we can access the internet and email. It have the smaller screen and keyboard to save the space. Then these netbooks are less powerful, so it use the more simplified operating system. Some of the netbooks are using Windows 7 starter operating system. Some of the netbooks are using simplified version of Linux. Did you get it?
Next question is, what is a mobile device? These mobile devices we can fit in our palm of our hand, or we can keep it in our pocket. So we can say this one handheld computers. Did you get him? Some of the mobile devices are tablet computers, e-readers and smartphones.
Now we will see about tablet computer. These tablet computers are like the laptop computers. It is more portable than the laptop computers. These tablet computers have the virtual keyboard. Virtual keyboard, do you know? All the touch screen mobile have the virtual keyboard. Any keyboard is attached to that mobile phone? No. Whenever we are need, when we are pressing the corresponding place, you can get the keyboard. That is a virtual keyboard. Whenever we need, that keyboard is appear on the screen. Whenever no need, it will disappear. That is a virtual keyboard. Did you get it? This virtual keyboard have the keyboards or touchpad. In this tablet computer, entire screen is touch. So we can use the finger as the mouse pointer. Wherever we are touching on the screen, that all place is sensible. Okay. These tablet computers are used for web browsing, watching videos, reading e-books, and playing games. Then some of the main features of these tablet computers are mobile OS, solid state drive, Wi-Fi and 3G or 4G, Bluetooth. Now we will see about mobile OS. OS means operating system. Without the operating system, we cannot work on any device. Then these mobile devices are using various operating systems. Examples, Android and iOS. These two operating systems are used for these mobile devices. Next one is solid state drive. The tablet computers are usually use the solid state drives. It is same as the RAM in the ordinary computers. These solid state drives are used to boot up and open the program quickly. Boot up I will explain in the later class. Okay. What is the use of the solid state drives? It is used to boot up and open the program quickly. Then it is also used for long time than the ordinary hard disk. Now we will see about Wi-Fi and 3G. This one all of you know. Is it nowadays this Wi-Fi and Wi-Fi 3G and 4G is very common one. Why we are using this Wi-Fi? Wi-Fi is used to connect the internet. Then next 3G and 4G are the data plan. When we are recharging the mobile, that time we are using the plans. Next one is Bluetooth. Bluetooth is used to connect the external devices. The external devices, what are the keyboard, mouse, scanner, printer, like these devices are external device. These devices are connected using this Bluetooth. How these laptop computers have the fewer port to save the space. That's why we can't connect this directly connect the devices. So we need the wireless connection. This wireless connection is given by the Bluetooth. Next mobile device is e-book reader. E-book reader is similar to tablet computers. It mainly used for reading e-book. E-book means electronic book that is in digital form. It may be downloaded in the internet or it is stored in the computer. Examples of these e-book readers are Amazon Kindle and Barnes and Noble Nook. These e-book readers can have either e-paper display or LED. Now we will see the e-paper. E-paper full form is electronic paper. It display in black and white. It look like an actual page in the book. It use the backlit. Backlit means backlight. Suppose we are take out our mobile phone in front of the full sun time. Can you see from your mobile? We can't see because of that more light, so we can't see. That's why this device is used the backlighting. Okay. Then next is this device is most popular in the people because of it is reduce the eye strain. These devices cannot be used for videos and other applications. Next e-book reader is LCD. It is same as the tablet and the laptop computer. It is more difficulty to view bright sunlight because the image is washed out. So we can't see in the bright sunlight. This LCD screen can display in colors. This is used for reading magazines or books with photos. The last mobile device is smartphone. You all of you know about this smartphone. This is a mobile device. What are the functions in the mobile devices? All of you know, used for web browsing, watching videos, reading e-book and playing games. Okay, these smartphones are using the touch screen and the operating system as the other tablet computers. It has the virtual keyboard. Some of the smartphones have the physical keyboard. Virtual keyboard already I explained. Physical keyboard. Ordinary laptop and the desktop computer have the keyboard. That is a physical keyboard. This smartphone also used to access the internet. Okay. Then it have the 4G and 3G data plan for the cell services. It used the Wi-Fi to connect the internet. Understand?